G'day, welcome back to Buildsome and the 15th presentation in the series on the Australian Timber Framing Code, or AS1684. This one's going to be about working out the size for your hip, or as it's referred to, your hip rafters, which also includes your valleys. So if we look at the rules and the tables, we need to look at rule 7.2.13 and table 7.6. So rule 7.2.13 doesn't tell us too much about the hip and valley rafters. It just says that if we're going to use the hip and valley rafter to support our purlins, then we may need to strut our rafters, or we may need to design them with that load in mind. Okay, so we sort of need to think about whether we're going to have to use our hip and valley rafters to strut our purlins. Okay, so that's all that says. And we've already looked at rule 7.3.17 for other members and components, which basically tells us we need to use table 7.6. So table 7.6, we can look at hip rafters, and we can see it's broken up into two areas. We have stress grades F11, MGP15 minimum, and we have stress grades less than F11, MGP15, which we are because we're using MGP10. So we use this line here, and it says that our hip rafter needs to be 50 greater in depth than the rafters. Minimum thickness as for the rafters. Now notice, it doesn't say rafter plumb cut, it says rafters. So what we need to do, we know that our rafters were 140. So 140 plus 50 gives us 190 mil. So we're going to use 190 mm deep hip or valley members, and the thickness was as per our rafters. So our rafters were 140 by 35, so we're going to use 190 by 35 hip and valleys. Okay, so that's how we work out the size of our hip and valley members, or hip and valley rafters, and in this case we're going to use 190 by 35.